The first published research on these new Nuance Audio hearing glasses is out. And I have to tell you, I am blown away. But at the same time, I've been looking at it with a keen eye. And whilst the research is strong, I still think there's some work to be done by Asilo Luxottica and the Nuance Audio hearing glasses team. Okay, so firstly, I have to start today with an apology. I have always cited that there were an estimated 30 million people in the US alone with hearing loss, which came from reliable sources across the web. However, it's possible that I have significantly underestimated the actual figure of those of you out there with some form of hearing loss. With alternative sources, including the one cited in today's study, now estimating that in the US alone, there are potentially 73 million people with some form of hearing loss in the US. 73 million. Now, to give you an idea of how ginormous this number is, Michigan Stadium, home to the Michigan Wolverines, has a capacity of 109,000 people. So, if you were to build 670 stadiums side by side and fill them with people, that would demonstrate the number of people in the US alone with hearing loss, never mind the rest of the world. Now, I'll finish with the numbers in a second, but they're pretty compelling and definitely worth sharing. And the main reason that we're here today is of that 73 million people, 90% fall within the mild to moderate category of hearing loss, which often goes untreated. And these are exactly the people that the FDA had in mind when in 2022, legislation was passed in the US for over-the-counter hearing aids, which are essentially hearing aids that you can buy over-the-counter and program them yourself using nothing more than your smartphone. Good idea, eh? Well, in theory, yes, and some big names joined the race to develop the first over-the-counter hearing aids, from Bose, Sennheiser, Hewlett-Packard, to the likes of Sony and Jabra, with their main goal being to make hearing aids more accessible and affordable. But guess what? It didn't work. And adoption rates for over-the-counter hearing aids have been far lower than expected. Why? Well, in my opinion, there are still, despite the reduced cost versus traditional hearing aids, issues around price, stigma, and performance. So the big question is, why don't more people sign up for hearing aids? In fact, I'd love to throw that question out to you. Yes, you, watching me now. Drop me a note in the comments on whether you have a hearing aid or not, and if not, is there a reason you've delayed getting yours? Or were you an early adopter? In my opinion, there are three main barriers stopping people having hearing aids fitted, especially in the US, and I'll come on to why I say that in a second. So firstly, it's price. There is no question that traditional hearing aids can be expensive, and this all depends on your location. I do think that it is without question worth the money if I consider the ongoing care that I provide to my patients in clinic. However, not everybody can afford them. You see, in the US, before over-the-counter hearing aids came to existence, if you had a hearing loss but couldn't afford hearing aids, then you were pretty much stuck with the non-clinically proven trash that you can buy online. So over-the-counter hearing aids clearly needed to happen. Whereas in the UK, for example, if you're in the exact same scenario, you can visit your GP who will refer you for an audiological evaluation and then you'll be fitted with a free set of hearing aids. So do I think that over-the-counter hearing aids have resolved this price issue in the US? Well, there are a wide range of over-the-counter hearing aids available, with prices starting from just under $100 going all the way up to $3,500, which is still hardly cheap. And for that money, I personally think that you'd be better off to go and visit an audiologist for a traditional set of hearing aids, which would be more advanced, plus you'd have their ongoing support. So I personally think that so far, this is one reason that we haven't seen a huge uptake in over-the-counter hearing aids. Yet. So price is without question a factor, but it's not the whole story, in my opinion. I feel that the second reason for those of you out there with hearing loss avoiding traditional hearing aids is the stigma associated with wearing hearing aids. Very simply put, no one wants to be reminded that they're not 21 anymore. Why do I raise this? Well, I think that whilst we've had some big names join the OTC hearing aid race, every one of those devices looks exactly like a hearing aid. So if you happen to be watching from any of the big tech giants that I mentioned earlier, you have the power to completely revolutionize the way that hearing aids look, because so far, nothing has changed. Yet. And then the third and final flaw that I currently see with other over-the-counter hearing aids on the market is, very simply put, that they're not performing as well as hearing aid users need. Yet. And so this is where the Nuance Audio hearing glasses step in. So Asilo Luxottica have taken these three factors, that's both price, stigma, and performance, and then they've made them the foundations of their new Nuance Audio hearing glasses, aiming to tackle hearing loss in a completely new way by building over-the-counter hearing aids directly into their most stylish models of glasses. So the big question is, do they tick all of the boxes? Nuance Audio are boasting that they are, first of all, cheaper than traditional hearing aids, coming in at just over $1,000 for a pair, therefore reducing, but in my opinion, not eliminating price issues. You would have no idea that they're not a regular pair of glasses, which therefore eliminates issues around stigma. And then finally, as far as OTC hearing aids go, they think that they're second to none when it comes to performance in terms of hearing speech in background noise. So let's take a look at them. Nuance Audio have released these rechargeable glasses in two different styles, both round and square. There are three different sizes available, and they're also available in two of Asilo Luxottica's most popular colors. That's black and burgundy. So, based on their research, they should cater for everybody. And yes, you heard me correctly, I said rechargeable glasses. They come with a charging pad which uses induction charging, with a full charge giving 10 to 11 hours in a mixed hearing setting. Or they're boasting that if you spend a great deal of time in background noise, you'll get around 7 to 8 hours from them. If you ask me, whilst this isn't ideal, it's better than most of the battery lives that you get from other OTC hearing aid manufacturers out there. Now, all of the electronics are built into the glasses themselves, so there are no wires or extra components necessary, which, in my opinion, is especially appealing, as hearing aid glasses that have appeared in the past have had a wire or tube running down from the arm to the user's ear. Whereas these use open ear speaker technology, maximizing comfort and directing the sound to the entrance of your ear canal, and believe it or not, you are the only person that can hear the sound. And then the biggest unique selling point about this technology versus any other over-the-counter hearing aid is their use of directional beamforming technology, which is being fed by six microphones, which are all strategically placed on either the front or the arms of the glasses. Why is this such a big deal? Well, some other OTC hearing aids have two microphones that work in tandem, whilst the six microphones on these allow them to use directional beamforming to focus more aggressively on the sound that you want to hear and zone out the sounds behind and to the side of you. So what more could I possibly want from an OTC hearing aid? Well, I mean, I'd like to see some evidence. So let's break down their research. Now guys, if you've made it this far into the video, then come on, admit it, you're learning something new. And I haven't even started on some of these incredible hearing aid features yet. So press that like button, and whilst you're at it, you should probably subscribe too, because you definitely want my videos reviewing new technology to appear on your YouTube home screen, don't you now? Now, starting out, I just want to say that the research paper that I'm covering today was commissioned by Nuance Audio themselves, and I have a great amount of respect for those involved. Hey, Tammy and Douglas. And whilst I'm excited to break it down for you today, as with all hearing aid manufacturers, their numbers have to be interpreted knowing that they've come from the Nuance Audio team. So as well as hearing them out, I would also recommend that you head over to the Hearing Tracker website, of course, after you've watched today's video, in which we've broken down each hearing aid manufacturer and performed our own independent testing using the same parameters, so you can directly compare each manufacturer. Now, quite positively, this paper, titled An Over-the-Counter Hearing Aid Option for People with Self-Perceived Mild to Moderate Hearing Loss, Nuance Audio Hearing Aid Glasses, references these separate studies. Firstly, one by Harold R. Belli, who put the Nuance glasses head-to-head with traditional hearing aids to measure their effectiveness. And they did find, or he found, that the Nuance Audio hearing aid glasses perform better than two premium prescription hearing aids in noisy situations. Interesting. A second study by Harold Arbelli, using real-world testing and feedback, highlighted that users reported clearer sound, better speech recognition, and less listening fatigue in daily situations against wearing no hearing aids at all. And then the third study worth mentioning referenced user satisfaction using the International Outcome Inventory, or IOI, which highlighted that Nuance Audio scored higher than traditional hearing aids in 5 out of 7 key areas. These included use, benefit, residual activity, limitations, satisfaction, residual participation restriction, impact to others, and then quality of life. And so there you go. These are clearly the solution to all of your worldly problems. Well, okay, not quite. As you know, you'll always get a balanced review when I'm breaking down any technology or associated research. And whilst this data is compelling, there are a few areas that I think that Nuance Audio need to focus their attention on to be sure that this data is flawless. So Tammy, Douglas, if you're watching from the Nuance Audio team, and I know you will be, I have a few thoughts to take your research to the next level. Firstly, I would love to see more of everything. So more people, more diversity, more age ranges, and in my opinion, most importantly, more time. Now, these studies ranged from between 19 to 43 participants. They consisted of older adults with no long-term follow-up to assess their adaptation, their durability, and their satisfaction over extended use. So yes, the research is technically good enough to draw some conclusions. However, in reality, it's insufficient to generalize findings for a broader population. Secondly, and I've got to admit, I'm a little disappointed that this has been overlooked. The prescription devices were only set up, as far as I'm aware, and tested using a first fit setup, meaning that they've literally been taken out of the box, had the hearing test results added, and then the users have been asked to give their feedback. That's not how we fit hearing aids, is it? And again, this feeds into the short-term nature of the research. I personally would like to see the same research performed looking at long-term outcomes after hearing aid users have had their hearing aids optimized correctly using both real ear measurements and then being followed up correctly. I do think that the findings would be quite different if this was the case. And then thirdly, I would love to see how these hearing aids cope in a group situation or with people that you're not looking at. The thing is, directional beamforming technology is great and it will allow the microphones to focus in front of the user. So in a one-to-one situation, it will be fantastic, and they are. However, what if there are 2, 3, 4, or 5 people in a restaurant? If the microphones are directly facing in front of you, then technically, is it going to be more difficult to hear the people that are sat around you in a group situation? So in my opinion, the next part of research would be great to understand this area as well. The reason I say this is because traditional hearing aid manufacturers have in fact gone away from a fixed directional setup, focusing towards an adaptive directional setup in recent years for exactly this reason. So I literally received my pair of Nuance glasses last week and I have a lot of work to do to put them through their paces. So watch this space for my full review, which will be coming out soon. If I were you, I wouldn't even consider buying them though until you've seen this video covering the best hearing aids of 2025.